Today is an upper body dynamic day, so we're going to warm up our upper body. We're not going to worry a whole lot about a lower body warm up. First thing we're going to do, arms out to the side, hands pointed up. We're going to start small circles. Small rotating into big circles. We're going to warm up that shoulder joint. Bigger, 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 until we have real big circles with the arms, all right? We're going to do the same thing to the back. Arms, starting small, rotating. Bigger, 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 bigger. We're going to have our arms 90 degree angle at the elbow. Coming up, 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 up. Warming up that rotator cuff. Then down, down, down. All right, we're going to come here. Elbows touching the side. Arm, elbow at a 90 degree angle. Crossover. We're going to switch the crossover, okay? Switch. Right hand on top, right hand on bottom. Right hand on top, right hand on bottom. Then we're going to do chain breakers, all right? Chain breakers. We're going to start with head up and down, okay? What this does is some neck mobility. It allows for, when you're in a fight, it allows you to remain focused. When your head's getting knocked around in a fight, it allows you to remain focused when you're moving, when you're running. We're picking a spot on the wall in front of us, and we're maintaining eye contact, we're maintaining visualization without getting dizzy, and with moving our head around. All right, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go from eyes from side to side. We're gonna pick a spot on the wall on each side of us, and we're gonna go switch, switch, switch. The eyes are picking up before the head does. You're trying to get your eyes around before you get your head around. It's the same thing. We're getting used to being able to move quickly, transition from target to target. If you're shooting, it's gonna be transitioning from target to target, eyes before back, okay? Spinning to the back, spinning to the back. You're throwing a spinning back fist. You don't wanna ever hit anything without realizing what you're hitting. So your eyes are spinning first, and then you're making contact with the fist. You're gonna pick a spot on the wall directly behind you, spin and make contact, all right? Now, we'll just turn it into just only a mobility, spinal mobility, okay? We're getting full spinal mobility, warming up the spine. Back to the head, all the way around, neck rolls, all the way around. Still keeping that spot with your eyes on the wall directly in front of you. Other way. Now we're going to go hands protecting our face, feet shoulder width apart, and we're going to go side to side. Still a warm up, still mobility, but we're making it a functional movement and we're protecting ourselves. Our elbows are protecting our floating rib, they're protecting our liver, they're protecting anything from a strike coming in here. Our hands are protecting our temples, all the way being able to roll back and protect the nerve cluster behind the ear, protecting the eardrum, okay? And what we're doing also is mobility, side-to-side mobility, sobbing and weaving in a fight. Rotator cuff, warm up, you're gonna raise your arm parallel with the ground. Your elbow is always gonna be at 90 degrees, and you're gonna wanna set that band right at where your elbow is. You're gonna step forward here, everything straight. Straight here, parallel with the ground, 90 degrees, and you're gonna rotate forward. Alright, from this position, you're simply gonna turn around. You're gonna be in that hand position that we started in before. Alright, you're gonna have 90 degrees in the elbow, it's gonna be flat here. Straight to the band here, and you're just gonna pull straight up. Right now we're warming up the rotator cuff. Still, you wanna go very light. You have very small muscles holding your shoulder in socket, and with any amount of heavy weight, there's really no possibility and no way to warm them up with a lot of heavy weight. This is what we consider a prehab warm-up, prehabilitation, meaning that we're doing a warm-up that will prevent injury, or for the purposes of preventing injury. Eccentric pull-ups on our upper dynamic day. Eccentric pull-ups should technically be more weight than you can do concentrically. So it should be more weight than you can do a normal pull-up with. Today, this is all the chains I have, so it's not going to be a true eccentric pull-up, but I'll still get some eccentric work out of it. Now ballistic military press, throw